Well, howdy folks, and welcome to another episode of Vern's Misadventures. In this one, I'm going to be upgrading my iBook G3. We're going to be increasing the hard drive size to 60 gigs or so with an SSD. And we're also going to be adding 512 megabytes of RAM, plus, of course, whatever's built in, so it'll come out to be a little bit more than that. At any rate, it's not going to be a comprehensive how to disassemble, how to rebuild guide because, well, truth be told, I just followed the 8-bit guy's teardown guide. And so if that's what you need, I've got a link in the description and you can go ahead and watch that video instead. If you're still here, yeah, let's get on with it. I'll just do a montage of the teardown rebuild and then we'll talk about the software installation and whatnot and any lessons learned during the operation. So let's get into it. So I encountered a couple difficulties putting the laptop back together. First, I put screws in the wrong places when I was reinstalling the RFI shield. There was a screw in the hole I needed for the optical drive, and I also had a screw in one or more holes for the top cover. So I had to take it apart to fix that. And I didn't realize at that point, but the clutch cover had some tabs hanging out the bottom of the laptop. And it was not going to close properly. Now the clutch cover, of course, is that blue piece that goes between the two hinge points held on by the three small screws. So at any rate, I had to tear it back down to get back to the point where I could take the hinges off again and remove the top and put it back in properly. But I wanted to mention it because if you're thinking about doing this to your iBook, you'll want to be aware that that clutch cover could pose a problem for you, and maybe you won't have to put yours together 2-3 times like I had to do mine. So anyway, on to the software. So we're all back together. And now we're trying to see if we can maybe install something. Alright, so here's our macOS Tiger.
I set the clock.
Okay. So we finally got Tiger installed on this thing. There it is, macOS 10.4. Took a couple tries, and what I ended up doing was I thought maybe my disk image was corrupted, or I didn't know what was going on. But when we got to disk 4 on a full installation, it failed. So I did a custom installation, and I deselected the language packs and the printer drivers. I don't think I deselected anything else, but just getting rid of those two things, it didn't need disk 4 anymore. So yeah, it installed. Then it asked me to enter my information. So cool, huh? So now if we look in Finder, instead of saying Blueberry iBook as the user, it's got me. I guess there's no save button on this one. Save. Okay. So then it asks you to save after you close it. All right. So it's been a couple of months since I recorded the first part of this video, and since I did the upgrade, some things have moved around, changed around in the work area, and so, you know, it is what it is. So here's what we're doing here. So if we go to About This Mac, we'll see that we are indeed running Mac OS X version 10.4.11. It shows that it's got the 300 meg PowerPC G3 and 544 megabytes of RAM. So our upgrades were successful. We'll go to Finder. Let's close this. iBook 1. Let's see, if we control click, we should be able to get info on iBook 1. So iBook 1 has a capacity of 34.86 gigabytes. And iBook 2, if we get info on that, is 20.78 gigabytes. It's unallocated space at this time. I was saving that for a Linux installation or maybe a FreeBSD, something along that lines of a modern operating system, so that we might could do internet tasks. Now, on the subject of internet tasks, I don't have the network connected right this second, but I did install the Interweb PPC. It is a port of Firefox for PowerPC. If I can find it, I'll leave a link in the description where you can get that. You can download binary, and I believe that there's a project on GitHub where you can download everything you need to build it for your machine. But I was able to get a binary here. What it is, a modern web browser, and I was able to use that to download this wallpaper, which of course is a Tiger wallpaper. How about that, huh? So I want to talk about how I managed to get OS 9 on here and why it was even necessary. So if we look in here in our root file system, look in our classic folder, we find that we have our System 9 folder, Stuff It Deluxe, and some utilities, right? Let's see. Okay, so point being, I was able to find an image of Mac OS 9, and it was compressed, and I downloaded that, and I was able to just move the entire Mac OS 9 system right into my root file system of Mac OS 10.4. So that is in effect how I managed to install OS 9. It's not the way I wanted to do it. It's not the way I probably should have done it, but after several failed attempts of trying to install OS 9, it would just seem like the most practical way at that point. I was just able to drag it over, and that's that. So before we run over to OS 9 and show you some of that, what I'd like to do is talk about what we can do in OS 10. So in 10.4 Tiger, we can use the aforementioned Interweb PPC to do some light web browsing. It is painfully slow, but it is possible to use it to do some web browsing. Now, off camera, I also installed an airport card, which I tested just yesterday, and it does work. However, because it only supports WEP security, which is pretty pretty weak security for these days. I was able to connect to it through my phone, and the phone was able to connect. I had to use an open wireless hotspot, so I just had to make it open with no password protection or anything. And obviously that's highly insecure and highly unadvised, but it does work that way. So basically, your two options for connecting to the web wirelessly using the airport card is either if you can set up a WEP connection, or you just use an open with no password protection whatsoever. So it might or might not work at Starbucks. I don't know what their settings are. If they support older hardware, like say wireless B, as long as they support wireless B on up, then it should work. But other than that, it may not. I don't know. I haven't done it yet. I may never take it to Starbucks. Point being, I could. So there's one thing you can do in 10. Another thing you can do, of course, I've got the Office suite on here. You can do any kind of word processing or Excel or PowerPoint. So you can do Office type work with it. Let's just go ahead and open Word document so we can close it finally. All right. And then at this point, we should be able to quit Word. So, yeah, that's another thing you could do with it, okay? You'll notice I have the VLC media player. It's virtually useless for playing any kind of video. You can play music with it. It will play audio CDs using the QuickTime player or iTunes player. So, other than that, you got the nostalgia factor. It's fun to play with. You could write a Word document. You could write a PowerPoint presentation. You could do an Excel spreadsheet. Other than that, 10.4 Tiger is useless on this thing because everything just runs too slow on it. Okay. So in order to do anything else, what you'll have to do is you got to go to your System Preferences. Now, you have the ability in the setup to open OS 9 classic applications and run them in kind of a virtual OS 9 environment. This thing is way too slow to do that in any kind of effective manner. You only have 300 megahertz to play with here, and to add a second operating system on top of OS 10.4, which already kind of bogs the system down, is just not a good thing to do. So what we'll do is we'll just go to startup disk here, and we will select to restart the computer into, well, when it comes up here, and we'll start it into Mac OS 9.2.2. We'll just restart. Yeah, so I purposely tried to stay quiet for a little bit so you could listen and hear that it's silent operation now. No more of that clanking and banging around with the mechanical hard drive, which is nice to not have to hear that. It boots somewhat faster than it did with the old hard drive. However, you're still not having any kind of blinding speed or anything like that for sure. Regarding the airport, so there's the airport control panel and whatnot. So it can't connect to my home network because I don't have it set up for WEP. I tried setting up, you know, you can do open a hotspot with Windows 10 if you have a wireless card or adapter connected to it, you can do that. But there's no way to set the security parameters that I could find. Now, I could be wrong about that, but I wasn't able to figure it out in the time that I had allotted for the project. What's great about OS 9, and what's great about this little iBook, is there's plenty of games available for it. And I found some that I was able to download and install. So, if we go here, the easiest way to find them here is to simply go to the recent applications. And so I got this 3D Toad Panic. And we'll go ahead and call it a fast Mac because for the timeline, this is a pretty fast Mac. for the time that this game was made available. We're going to do keyboard, I think. So this is kind of like a 3D version of Frogger. Well, it's not your modern computer. It's far and above anything you'd find on the Apple II or the Commodore 64, Commodore 128 that we've been playing with so much here of late too. So if we so we can run across the road here. I think we're gonna run out of time. Then we jump on the log, gonna jump on the grass. Pick up the extra bonus point. Oops, well, I almost got it. Point is, I can play better than this. For some reason, I can't talk and play at the same time. So we'll go ahead and quit this one. I'll show you another game that can play. It's pretty fun, this one here. So I could see using this like at Ford while I was waiting for an oil change or something. You know, just to play with, pass the time. As far as doing real productive work, well, as I said, you could write documents, do Excel spreadsheets, whatnot. PowerPoint presentation, if you needed to set one of the, have one of those done, you could do that. Yeah, let's see what else I got on here. So anyway, that was a cute game. And then recent applications. Got this solitaire game, right? So I was playing that last night, apparently. And I got myself stuck. So, let's see what else. Recent applications. This is a pretty fun game I was able to find. It's called Heart Quest. Apparently the developer made it for his wife for Valentine's Day. And your goal here is to just kind of float around and pick up all the hearts without getting stuck in the fly strip or running out of time. So nice, I made it. So if you run out of time or if you get stuck on the fly strip like that, it holds you up. And like I say, it's a timed deal. It's a timed deal, so you will run out of time eventually and the game will be over, as demonstrated. Huh. So let's see, how do we get out of this game? Quit. So anyway, you can play this game here. Just kind of new game of Pac-Man. And this game runs much faster on 9 than it does on 10.4. 10.4 is a little too heavy for this machine. And since about the only advantage to running 10.4 is that you can get a modern web browser for it, I suppose it might have been worth it, maybe not. So we've all seen Pac-Man before. Quit that one. Let me show you some other games I found for it that are pretty cool. This Redneck Rampage is pretty neat, and it shows some of the graphics capability of the machine. So, if we go over here, we could load a new game. We'll say we want to do the outskirts. We'll take the wuss level. So anyway, you can move around with the arrow keys. So there's your zombies. You're gonna whack the zombies. So I'm not very good at these games, so I won't try to show you how awesome I am at the game. The idea was just to show what the computer could do. So we're gonna quit this one. I'll show you some other stuff, then we'll wrap up. Another fun game that I found for this is, where would it be? Is it in the applications? Let me see. Well, Creep Knight's a pretty cool little pinball game. Let's check that out. And Pinball 2. So you get this error, unable to play the movies, maybe due to lack of memory. Well, it could be. But as far as the game goes, it seemed to work okay.
Name your poison. Choose to play one table.
We'll just play this one. Okay.
Welcome to our castle. Stay for a spell.
Oh man.
Feed me now.
No, I won't bore you with my awesome pinball skills, but, or my speaking skills, apparently. So, let's see here. And here's another one. Applications. What else in here? Oh, here we go. Bugged them. We'll just demo it. You know what? I don't think I've ever played this. I think I installed it and forgot about it. Bugdom 2. I had the original Bugdom. Bugdom 1. Let's see. Let's play. The front yard. Okay, here we go. Yeah, let's see what happens when we pick this. Apparently not much. So anyway, this is a lot more than I had imagined the machine would be able to do. So that's pretty good. I'm just going to quit this application. And probably in the games folder. I need to get this organized. Oh, okay, yeah. Here. There it is. There's this demo again. Yeah, then you just start the game. It's got this neat little animation. Spider goes over. So on this one here, I have played this one a little bit. I won't say I know what I'm doing. Obviously. So you get over next to that. And then you can get things out of there, I guess. But at any rate, it's very similar to the other. I think that the intro and all that is a little nicer on the first one than it was on that second one, what I've seen of it. I wanted to eat though. There we go. So anyway, that's that. So that's pretty much what I wanted to show you here. As far as the use and whatever we can do with this machine. So kind of demo the machine a little bit for you. So Office in the web browser on OS X and all the games pretty much on OS 9. And it's a pretty decent experience. So there you go. Was it worth it? For the nostalgia it is for me. As far as the rest of it, I don't know. I got a lot more storage now, so I could install more games. I may end up expanding this and never installing the other operating systems. Or I may get around to it. Who knows? We'll see. But at any rate, that is the project. So with that, I want to thank you all for watching. I'd like to invite you to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And until the next one, y'all take care.